Let's begin with some big breaking update coming at this point in time, and this is connected to Sushant Singh Rajput's death probe. Bihar government has filed an affidavit in Supreme Court accusing Riya Chakraborty and her family members of coming in contact with Sushant Singh Rajput with the sole motive of grabbing crores of rupees off his money and later painting a false narrative about his mental illness. Let's go across to my colleague Harish joining us on the broadcast this morning. Harish, this is another sensational development in this case. Bihar government, it seems, has got some details.
Yes, that's right, Hina. Remember, Supreme Court had on the day on which it heard Riya Chakraborty's petition, sought a reply from the Bihar government regarding her plea for transferring the FIR probe to Mumbai. So Bihar government filed its affidavit today, and as you said, there are many startling revelations. It says it accuses Riya Chakraborty and her family members of coming in contact with Sushant Rajput with sole motive of grabbing crores of rupees of his money and later painting a false picture of his mental illness. And affidavit also says Chakraborty took Rajput to her house and started giving him overdose of medicine. Bihar police also says that despite total non-cooperation from Mumbai police, it has found several leads in the investigation and told the Supreme Court that since the probe points are scattered at many places in India, it suggested a CBI probe into Rajput's mysterious death. The petitioner and her relative desperately attempting to give impression to the deceased actor that he is suffering from mental illness for which he required treatment. The petitioner also took the deceased to her house where she started giving him overdose of medicine. It further states that in the complaint that petitioner also took all belongings of the deceased into her possession and made every attempt to keep deceased away from his family. And what is most startling is, Hina, is this para which says the deceased actor informed her sister that the petitioner will falsely implicate him if the deceased did not pay heed to her, which means that Riya Chakraborty, according to this affidavit, was constantly threatening Sushant that if he did not agree to her demands, she will falsely implicate him in many false cases. And in this affidavit also strongly justifies the FIR filed in Bihar, following which the same charges have been carried in a fresh FIR lodged by the CBI. The affidavit says that the state has complete jurisdiction and the locus standi to file an FIR because a part of course of action like Sushant Rajput was born and brought up in Bihar. His family was residing there, and consequences of the act of Riya Chakraborty is felt in Bihar. So there is a cause of action in Bihar, and the Bihar government is completely justified in lodging an FIR, and therefore the state can very well recommend an CBI probe also, which the center has now accepted and implemented by registering an FIR. So CBI has formally taken over the probe and the very same charges which was in the Bihar government's FIR, that is wrongful restraint, wrongful confinement, theft, cheating, and forcibly keeping Sushant away from his family, siphoning right. off his funds, all are there. So the Bihar government in the affidavit filed in the Supreme Court has completely justified by registration of FIR right. as Mumbai police has refused to file an FIR okay. despite passage of 50 days.
So these are some sensational claims that have been made by Bihar government in this affidavit that has been filed. Stay on with us, Harish. In fact, more updates coming as far as this case is concerned. As Sushant case gathers steam, Team Riya is totally cornered. Fearing tough questions from the probe agency, Team Riya has now offered excuses to skip ED summons. She was supposed to appear before the Enforcement Directorate today. 7th of August was the date of Riya Chakraborty with the Enforcement Directorate. But now, after giving COVID excuses, Riya is now citing pending hearing in the Supreme Court. In an email that was sent last night, Riya has said that she seeks postponement of summons as the matter is still underway in the top court. However, the plea has been rejected by the Enforcement Directorate. The ED case has got no connection with the hearing by Supreme Court. Vajula, my colleague, is now joining us on the broadcast. broadcast Vajula. So at least one thing is sure, that Riya Chakraborty is not going to honor the summon of Enforcement Directorate today. What happens next in this case? Because ED has clearly rejected the plea.
Prapriti, now if we look into this, there are a lot of angles that comes into play if Riya cancels the summon. As we already know, it has already been rejected by the Enforcement Directorate. But what happens now is that the technicality that the Riya's team has said that it is because of the lack of, there no clarity on the jurisdiction. As we already know, that ED has taken over this case from the angle of Bihar police, and that is why the Supreme Court has also said that they will be deciding on the jurisdiction. This is the technicality that the team Riya has used as of now to request the Enforcement Directorate that they should postpone their summon till Supreme Court hearing. Now it is only after Supreme Court's hearing that we'll get to know which state will have the jurisdiction of this case. So now the Riya's team, as we already know, that Shruti Modi is also another person which has been asked to come for summon here. But from the team Riya, if we see, the CA of Riya also had cited similar reasons yesterday, said that I cannot come here for summoning because of heavy rains in Bombay. So time and again we are seeing that people from the team of Riya have rejected the summoning or have requested that they should be postponed for either Supreme Court hearing COVID cases, high cases of COVID-19 or heavy rains in Bombay. So these are the things that have been cited, but the technicality is that the jurisdiction has not been decided. But
right.
But if you look into this, this entire angle of Enforcement Directorate is only after the financial
Absolutely.
Exploitation
These
that
are
the father has
alleged. Issues, and perhaps that's something that the ED will now be focusing on. Stay on with us, Vajula. My colleague Bhavtosh joining us on the broadcast as well. Bhavtosh, so now the plea by Riya's camp has been rejected by the Enforcement Directorate. What can the ED do in this case from here on, considering that Riya Chakraborty is not planning to honor the summon?
Well, ED is within its right to even bring her for questioning. The teams can go in Mumbai. If they know her location, they can bring her to the ED's office in Balad Estate, which is in the Fort area of Mumbai, and then question her. ED has cited the Supreme Court's order that came 2 days back, in which they have said that no kind of protection has been given to Riya Chakraborty. So they are within their right to carry out investigation. The Supreme Court has not put a stay on the investigation. Moreover, they have time and again clarified that they are only looking into possibility or a suspected illegal money transaction. And they have said that if Riya is claiming that she has documents to prove that both these properties belong to her and that they were not illegally purchased, then why is she hiding from the Enforcement Directorate? If she has all the documents, all bank statements, she could just come and join the investigation. As Vaji was rightly saying, that there is an attempt by people close to Riya Chakraborty not to join the probe, whether it is her CA Ritesh Shah, twice he has missed the summons, and also Riya Chakraborty. Meanwhile, Sushant Singh Rajput's chartered accountant joined the probe on the very first day, that's on Monday. ED has said that they are looking into all aspects of this case, and they have said that right steps will be taken. If required, they will also try to bring Riya to their office in Mumbai.
Okay, stay on with us. Bhavtosh, let me go back to Vajula. Vajula, you've been in Mumbai since last couple of days. Where is Riya Chakraborty really? Because we don't know anything about her whereabouts.
Well, from all we know that she is in Bombay, but where is she is something that we have been asking the question to Mumbai police. We've also been looking around. Her whereabouts are still unknown, but from all we know is that she is in Bombay, because the cases are being heard that she'll be called in for investigation by the Mumbai police is also what we know. And because they had a summoning for Riya today also, but the Mumbai police also is not giving answers. They're also saying that they're clueless about Riya's whereabouts is also something surprising, because they did not help them, Bihar police, in this entire matter before the Supreme Court intervened and said that they will decide on the jurisdiction. So this clearly gives you an idea that Team Riya or Riya Chakraborty and her family are somewhere or the other trying their best to evade all these technicalities and not be present till the Supreme Court hearing is going on.
Okay. Bhavtosh, the irony is that it was the same Riya Chakraborty who was asking for a CBI probe when the Mumbai police was probing this case. She also went to the questioning by Mumbai police as well. She did answer the questions of Mumbai police. Later, she herself asked for a CBI probe, and when actually the case has been given to CBI and ED is probing the financial angle, she's nowhere to be seen.
It is for this very reason that suspicion arises as to why Riha is doing this. If she has not committed any offense or any crime, then she should just appear before the investigating agency. Now, yesterday also, the CBI went ahead and filed a case of abetment to suicide against Riha Chakraborty, her family members and close friends and associates. So she is in big trouble. There are both these agencies are federal probe agencies which have overarching powers. And as you rightly said, that she in fact had tweeted on 14th of July, if I'm not mistaken, that the probe should be given to CBI. At that point of time, she was not happy with Mumbai police investigation. Now she has approached the Supreme Court saying that she wants the probe to be given back to Mumbai police. Now Mumbai police have not done anything in this case. In past 50 days, they have only carried out inquest proceedings and their investigation has been all over the place. They have not found any concrete lead. Now, as a few minutes back, we did show the affidavit of Bihar police, which clearly mentioned that Mumbai police is trying to bury the truth as far as this case is concerned. And ED has said that because no protection has been given to Riha Chakraborty, if required, they will try to find her and bring her for questioning the same manner in which they managed to locate Samuel Miranda, who was in fact summoned, and then he was taken to Balad State office and questioned twice by the Enforcement Directorate.
Right. Thank you very much, Bhavtosh, as well as Vajula, for the moment, for joining us with all of those details. We'll be coming back to you on this angle of the story in just a bit.